Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to create a Timbaland style track. And Timbaland's so versatile, you really can't pin him down to one specific approach because he produces from the mind of the artist. So you have to figure out who you're producing for. So today we're going to create a Jay-Z style beat in the mind of Timbaland. So some people are like, are we creating a Jay-Z beat? Are we creating a Timbaland beat? Well, these high-level producers don't produce just whatever they want to make. They produce for a specific person, and that's what elevates them to such a high level. So Timbaland's style is very percussion heavy and mostly wood percussion. So you want to really dig into your wood percussion samples. So let's go to battery. Let's go to samples. Let's go to drums. And let's go to wooden. And here you have a full collection of wood percussion you can use to get you started with the rhythm. So you want to find anything. I mean, it doesn't have to be normal. It can be experimental. Timbaland's known to kind of push the envelope and still keep it hip hop or still keep it R&B. So you can really dig for your style. Now, first, before you select your percussion, let's get a decent tempo. So let's right click. Let's tap it out. We're going to go for like an old school kind of rhythm as far as the speed of it. It's not going to be like a trap rhythm. So I'm just going to pick what interests me. I like this sound. We can layer that. You have so many options. It's, you know, there's no one way to do it. Just find what inspires you. That inspires me. I'm going to show you how to combine all these elements without really overly thinking about it. We're just going to take it one percussion at a time. Now also we need a shaker, which we'll get into in a sec. And also these moving percussions, you could really utilize those because people perceive those as kicks even though they're not kicks. I'll show you how to manipulate that. So we have enough percussion, I don't want to make this video too complicated. Now let's go to the shakers and let's just pick an old school type of shaker sound. Now, with anything else, it's best to have two options so you can create variation within your track. Now let's pick a kick and a snare. For that, I'm going to go to a more modern drum kit. Let's go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's go to X Drums. Let's pull up a kick. And let's grab a snare. Okay, and then we should have all the sounds we need. So we have a lot of sounds. We have probably over 10 sounds already. So the question is, where do you start from here? Now, before we go any further, let's actually pick a cymbal. We need cymbals to create that high frequency contrast from the high frequencies and low frequencies. So we use that to make our kicks more impactful, layering them with cymbals or high frequencies. Now we need a hi-hat, and that will do. So now we have everything we need. For this hi-hat, I'm going to trim the excess so that it's gets rid of that little thing in the middle in the beginning, which was silence. Let's close up our browser. So now we're going to start with the kick and snare. So we have the kick and snare down here. Let's go to a new pattern one. And before we dig into the sound, let's actually send everything to the mixer so we can start accounting for the sound. Let's double click, highlight everything in the channel rack, go to your mixer, right click, insert one, go to channel routing, route select the channels starting from this track. That will name everything in the mixer and route it directly. So now we have our kick and our snare. Let's start there. Now again, you have to come up with the vibe of the track. I mean, we didn't really set the vibe yet, so it's kind of ambiguous. But really think about how you're going to take this track. Is it going to be an Aaliyah type track, R&B? Is it going to be a Jay-Z hard drum sound? Is the sub bass going to take over? You really have to decide before you get started. So this one's going to be sub bass heavy. So I'm going to let the kick not be so active. I'm going to let the sub bass move around a little bit more. Now, we didn't pull up the sub bass yet, but that's what I have in mind. Now, this pattern doesn't need to be that long since we're 92 BPM. So let's create a variation. Let's clone that. Let's add a double kick at the end and add a little swing so that that double kick goes ba-boom instead of like a robotic. So now we have a nice swing, a nice boom bap-ish swing. and it humanizes our rhythm. So we only need those two to get started. So let's go to our playlist. Let's right click the patterns icon. Let's select pattern one. Let's right click, select pattern two. We're gonna hit control to highlight those and hit shift to duplicate whatever was highlighted. Shift, left click and drag. And you can create a 16 bar section. Now notice we're gonna separate a lot of the percussion into different patterns because having everything on one pattern creates a lot of confusion when it comes to arrangements. And this is why people get stuck when it comes to making variations in their song. So you have to separate the percussion just like you would drums. So when I separate drums, I usually go kick, snare, then a new pattern, I'll do the hi-hat, then another pattern, I'll do the cymbals. So let's do that. Let's go to our hi-hat. Now it's going to be a fairly simple hi-hat pattern because we're going to contrast the hi-hats with the percussion. So let's just right click and fill each two steps for the hi-hat. Very simple, keeping it kind of like old school. But for this hi-hat, it's a little too early. It doesn't fit in the groove. So let's click on the wrench tool and let's turn up time shift. This is going to micro delay the hi-hat behind the metronome. So it's pushing the sample a little to the right. If we were to do this in MIDI, we're delaying the sample. And that difference in time creates that nice pocket. That old school boom bap sound. You don't really need to do much. You don't have to go in and microscopically move around your hi-hats. It's just a simple technique you can use. Now on pattern four, let's just add the downbeat cymbal. And again, that's going to give more impact to that kick. But let's turn it down in the mix. It's a little too loud. Now on pattern five. Now the question is, are we going to layer the snares or are we going to pick either or? So I'm going to add in the second snare and see if we can combine these two. Now in the mixer, you have to pick which snare is more important. Okay, you can't have both at the max volume because they're fighting for attention. So I'm going to pull down the second one and layer that with the first. You can barely tell it's even there. Now some people like to create time delays between their snares to make the snare feel longer. So we're going to use the second half of this. We're going to use the second snare to create like a second half of the first snare. So let's increase the time delay, time shift. And this also helps your groove a bit. Okay, so that would work just by itself. So if you had to come down to a beat breakdown, you could just go with your hi-hat, your snare, and your kick. You don't really need anything else. So now we're going to get into percussion, which is taking this to the next level. Make sure we're not getting too many underruns, okay? And so I'm not going to start with the shaker. I'm going to start with the wooden elements first. And I like to separate percussion just like we separate kicks and the hi-hats. We're going to separate the percussion. So some of this percussion is like heavy wood percussion. Some is light wood. And some sounds like a kick. So we're going to separate all those and then the shaker. So we're going to have four different sections. So let's start with the light wood first. So for these, I like to say just record whatever is flowing through you. Just record, hit record, automation, and score. But for the video, there's a little lag, so you're not going to hear the perfect groove that I have in mind. But I'll record whatever I have in mind as we go. I like to turn on the metronome to help me keep track as well. Very simple. That one doesn't need to be so active. Now that first hit, since it came before the drop, we can delete that. We don't need it. Now we just got to make sure it's timed right. It's a little early, again because of the video. So let's hit shift right twice. Let's highlight those and hit shift right twice to micro move or micro shift those notes. So now that's taken care of. Move to another light wood element. And here, this one's probably gonna be more active. So let's get an idea of what we could do with this. So we're going to layer that with the snare. Now again, you can put this all on one pattern. So we're doing a lot of bouncy rhythms. Notice these notes fall on the same spot, okay? Because we're creating a quick and unexpected movement, which creates a nice swing back to our original pattern. Now for this sample, I'm gonna make sure it's a delayed behind the snare. And also turn these down, they don't need to be that loud. Let's find them. This one, and start panning your percussion. That's what separates Timbaland from everybody else. He pans his percussion almost every bar, or tries to, especially with his shaker songs in R&B. Now we need something to go more rapidly. So here's where we're gonna add a contrast with the hi-hat, something that kind of matches that speed. That kind of pattern. Okay, so for this one, it's a little sloppy, I could tell, because of the lag. So let's just move these over. Now keep in mind, all these elements have the swing meter affecting them. So you need to go to your wrench tool and turn off the swing mix level for the elements you don't want to have excess swing on the sound, because you already recorded it into MIDI live. So you don't need the computer to figure out more swing. So now let's push these back a little bit further. Again, they don't have to be super loud, so let's turn these down. Seems a little early for me, so let's hit shift right. Again, when all these combine, it creates a unique stack. So now we're getting into the lower percussion, so let's go to a new pattern. And let's start with these kind of abstract, figure out where they're gonna sit. So this one I'm gonna actually type into the sequencer because I want it to be locked into the swing. So let's add that. Notice how I added it right at the end, so when it loops back again, it has that kind of kick effect where it swings, it goes ba-boom, instead of like a computerized sequence. Let's turn that down in the mix. Does not need to be that loud. Now also, we're gonna create a nice time delay, so go to your wrench tool, turn up the time shift. So the key here is to make everything heard with different time differences. And now we have a unique groove. So now let's figure out if we can even use this. So let's record. I have an idea. Actually, let's just type it in the sequencer. Let's go to pattern 6. I think that's the perfect spot for it. The thing is, I don't want it to occur every bar, so let's clone this and get rid of it for pattern 7. And let's go pattern 7 and alternate between pattern 7 and pattern 6 every other pattern. So let's highlight those, hitting control shift and left click to highlight individual patterns. Go to select source and change it to pattern 7. So now it doesn't have that percussion. Now notice, without the metronome, we don't have a contrast. And that's why I say you have to create contrast so that we understand the groove. Okay, now let's go figure out our shaker pattern. Now the shaker, again, you want to record it or type it in, but you want to create a lot of variation. Okay, so that's all we're going to do here. So it goes, again, we're capitalizing on the fact that that bounce of the kick, that kind of that note right before the next beat or bar, we capitalize on that swing. And that's the effect we generally get in hip hop, is where the kick comes right before the snare. That's kind of where the hip hop drum patterns come from. Now this one, I had to hit another note to play it the way I wanted it. But you want to probably work on this rhythm. That's okay. I'm not going to spend an eternity going over the fine points, but it could be better as far as timing. Because any little time difference is going to change the way we perceive the groove. So now let's add shaker 2. This one's going to go chick, 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 chick. And that was a little sloppy, but let's pull it forward. I could tell it's a little late. So let's pull that forward. Using snap to grid none, delete that first note. Well, not delete it, but unselect it, deselect it. Now we have a nice contrast, something that's constant and on the metronome, and then you have other things which are off the metronome. So we understand the reference point, and that's what contrast is all about. Now this one I'm going to turn down in the mix. And let's start panning the shakers around. So for the panning decision, you have to figure out what the hi-hat's doing, because that's constant. So you need to pan that one way. You don't have to, but you can pan it one way. And you want to balance out frequencies when you pan as well. So these are both high frequencies, constantly working. So you need to balance those out. So pan one right, pan one left. And they have small time differences, which creates a unique stereo effect. The kick can probably be louder. So let's go and turn up the channel volume for the kick. So some tracks are going to have the snare more important than the kick. Some are going to have the kick more important than the snare. You need to find that moment in time. So now let's add the in-between drums. I think what we can do is do a unique little thing here. So let's go to the envelope for the sound, turn up the hold parameter so that when you play a key and let it go, it stops. So do this for each, because we want to have a lot of control over how long the samples play. So we get it more of a, we give it more of a sample feel. Okay, so I want to go again. We're going to capitalize on that kind of swing where we add the note right before the beat. So right there would work. Now we don't have to go into piano roll and fine tune, but what I'm going to do here is give it a defined note length so that it cuts off. It doesn't continue to play because we have that hold parameter on. And then we're going to clone this. But this time I wanted to go tututun. So I wanted to have like a tom roll feel, but not a tom drum. So I'm going to add these notes in, but this time I'm going to make sure they're on the grid so we can get the proper timing. But then go to, just make sure it has a note length. Now this was a little late. So let's add the note a little bit earlier. So I'm going to go boom, boom, boom. So it's just going to go down the sequence. But again, you have to give these note lengths so that we can cut it off at a certain time. Specifically right before the next sample comes in. So you don't have to have your snap to grid on none, but you need to make sure the note's cut off before the next note. And you could visually see the notes in the background. Now to get that feature, you go to piano roll options, go to helpers and activate ghost channels, and you'll see that stuff in the background. The grayed out notes in the background. Let's right click, give that note length for third sample. And it creates a unique kind of thing that we're not used to hearing. But it's really three different samples. Now, some people would think it's just one sample and we're tricking the listener. So that's how you create those unique percussive movements using the hold parameter and note length. Now, the question is this too early of a note? So let's listen into when the third samples triggered. I think the second one's a little early, so let's go to the wrench tool, turn that time shift up to delay it. I think, okay, that's better. So let's move on to the, I think we're done all the percussion and rhythm. Let's get onto the instrument. Now I like to start with the instruments first and then move into the sub bass, because starting with the bass kind of locks you into certain things that you can do musically. But unless the bass is fully inspiring the song, I wouldn't start with it. So let's figure out what we're going to do. I want to add a little, we have to get the vibe. Is it a soft vibe? Is it a piano vibe? You know, if you're confused, always start with a grand piano, because that's used in almost every genre and it works almost all the time for every song. So let's start with the grand piano. We're going to play around with the chords, see what works. And if this doesn't work, we'll get an idea of what will work. So let's figure it out. Because the piano can play all the octaves. That's another reason why we start with the piano. It can play bass, it can play high pitched. So as this loads, let's try some chords. I think we can do the kind of chord stab approach. The thing is, we're gonna have to make sure we're tuning the percussion. Another thing a lot of producers don't do is tune their instruments properly, and it makes your music sound off, even though you could be playing in the right key. If you don't have your instruments tuned properly, you could really mess up the way your song is perceived. So I'm just gonna play simple chords, A minor variations, and then show you how to kind of make variations for the A minor chord. But we're going to do that stab motion. Now, it's not going to be perfect, again, because there's a little lag in the video. Let's turn our metronome on. I'm just playing A minor with octaves in the bass. You have A, and then you have A minor. And I'll show you how to create those chord switches. At the end, I had to do a little modulation with the keyboard, so I couldn't finish off the chord progression the correct way. So I'm just going to copy that last chord stab at the end. So I was using a lot of things. My sustain pedal, I was using the octave switch on my keyboard to play different octaves for A minor. So that's how you create variation in your chord progressions. But before we get into all the variation, it's pretty simple. We went from A minor, and what I did was to create variation is just move the bottom two notes to the next notes within the scale. So in that case, I moved this note to the next white note down and moved the middle note to the next white note down. And that created the G major root, which would be GB, but then we maintain the top E note from the A minor. So that's how you create variations in your chords. And also think about octaves when you're playing. So right now I'm just going to quantize things and turn this down in the mix so we don't clip. But volume is one of the elements in making this piano aggressive, so you have to make sure it's loud enough to really get the bite from it. Turn off the metronome. I'm gonna add a limiter so we don't clip on the master. We'll be right back. You can hear some of the percussions out of tune, so we're gonna fix that. Now let's figure out the timing. I think it's a little early. Let's move that over. Okay, so at the end, again, I couldn't record this manually. It was just too much moving around. So let's just add these notes. We're going to duplicate those and move them over. Again, here I did the octave switch on the keyboard, and I played the same chord in three different octaves. So it's just A minor in three different octaves. And that's how you get a lot of variation in your piano. So use all that to your advantage, because I mean, that's what the MIDI controller is for. And also, again, I use the sustain pedal. So now we're going to figure out the percussion, which doesn't fit in this key. It's this one right here. It should be dun, dun, dun. So let's pitch it down. It fits better now. Okay, so now the piano works, so we don't really have to do much. You could add melody, you could add kind of hold the sustain pedal and play higher octaves of the scale, which would be all the white notes. So you can get more experimentive. Right now I'm just going to experiment with overtones. Again, playing octaves of the chord or playing the scale, which is all the white notes, just in a higher octave while holding that sustain pedal so it elongates the notes. And it creates a nice kind of background texture. So you could try that. That's what I'm going to do now, just freestyling it. No rhyme or reason, just using that scale, going up and down. And try it out. So I did a lot of, you can see here, I was holding the sustain pedal the whole time. So it looks confusing, but I was just going up and down the scale, as you could see. So I'm just going to keep what sounds good. Now at the end, it got kind of messy with that long pitch slide, so I might delete that. But I went down many octaves from A to A. Like that's probably a little too much. So let's turn it down. I'm just going to keep everything until it sounds bad. You can hear the notes aren't really triggering. That's because they're already, they're already there. If they overlap just a little bit, it will not trigger. So you need to move the notes over. Also, actually, no, that's not why. It's because the volume is so low. I played them very soft. You can barely hear it. So I'm just going to leave it as is. Now another way to get your piano to sound more aggressive. Some pianos let you change the way the lid is positioned. So you need to make sure it's an open lid piano. This one doesn't really give you that option, but some do. So you want to make sure the lid, the top of the piano, is open to get more high frequencies. Now Timbaland's very melodic, but the thing is, you need to have a vocal first because he supports the vocal with the melody, and you can tell that's typically what you do in, you know, in real production. When you have the vocalist record, you add stuff to the beat. And one of the things you could do is kind of embellish the melody by picking an element, a sound element, and layering it with the melody of the vocal. But since we don't have a vocal, it won't make sense by itself. But we'll try to create a melody. One more thing is the sub bass. So let's figure out if we're going to use an 808 or if we're going to go with the sub bass. So let's pull up our 808s from busyworksbeats.com. Let's go to 808 Science Drums. And we need a hard 808, something heavy. So here's one. And for the 808, we need to tune it. Now, in short, we have a whole video on tuning. You want to go to our YouTube page. It's a free video, how to tune any instrument in any DAW. I already know this needs to be tuned to A. I'm not going to waste time going through the steps. I'm just going to right-click on the root note A. So now I can play it like anything else on the keyboard. Now you have to decide, do you want that Drake kind of stop and go effect, or do you want the 808 to be elongated? I find Timbaland likes to maneuver his 808 a lot and really have control. So let's activate that envelope, turn the hold parameter up. And I'm just going to kind of wing it as far as the style. Then we can go back and change the notes. Like that kind of thing is what Timbaland would do. That kind of thing. So let's record that kind of movement. So I know I didn't get the timing right. We can always fix it in MIDI. Just wanted to show you how we approached it. So let's hit control up so we can hear it in a higher octave. Now notice we're starting on A because that's the key of the song. Now for the 808, I really want to have it quantized. So let's hit Alt Q to quantize. So I wanted to go bum 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 and then go to a lower note. So let's figure that out. One. Then I wanted to go to that A, just in a lower octave. Then we're going to copy that same rhythm. So that's on the fourth beat here. But this one, let's actually add a little more activity. Now again, you want to elongate the notes if you don't want it to sound stop and go-ish. Hit Control A, then hit Alt L to drag out the notes. Because you want it to sound, to make your drums sound more aggressive, you're going to have them on the beats, whereas softer beats have the drums in between the beats, like the one and two and, they have them on the ands, whereas harder beats have the drums on the one, two, three, four, the direct count of the bar and beats. See right here, it kind of creates a softness when we get in between the beats, those vertical dark lines. Now what I want to do here is a nice octave thing, so I'm going to show you how to kind of slide notes, which is really cool. But I'm not going to show you the typical overlay and slide the notes up. I'm going to show you a weirder way. So let's add another note. Let's double click that note and activate the slide parameter and do the same thing, adding another note here. So this A is going to slide up to this A, then it's going to hit the note A, and that higher octave is going to slide down over that amount of time, then it's going to hit the note A. So we get a different type of slide. And that might be too much of a jump, so let's pull that down a bit. A little more movement, and it's, you know, more unique. So now let's drop it into a lower octave. Let's hit Control A, Control Down, so we get that nice bass octave. Now you might not be able to hear this over, you know, laptop speakers, but hopefully you can hear the 808. I have subwoofers on, so I can really hear it. that's how you control your 808. And we're just going to repeat it. I don't want to spend too much time on the bass line, but you could take it further, obviously. Now you have to consider, do you want a synth element to kind of be the rapid movement? Again, everything's about contrast. We already have our piano doing the slow stuff. Now we probably need something to go faster. So without digging too much in the sound design, you can open up plugin like Nexus, which already has presets. We just need something that moves fast. So a quick pluck synth would be the go-to here. Let's just go through the different styles. This one I know is a hit sound. It's a little too belly. Something like this. That was pretty simple and it fits perfectly. It has the right low pass sound where it's nice and muffled, and we can create a nice repetitive loop without it sounding loopy, and that's because the rest of the song is doing all the work. So let's figure out the note. So it's going to be starting at C. Let's open up the piano roll, and you could do octaves too if you get bored of the one. I just like this octave here. Now again, it sounds robotic because we didn't create a time delay yet. So we need to time delay the Nexus here. Let's go to the wrench tool, turn up time shift. So it has a nice time difference, like everything else. Of course, you can turn it down in the mix so it's not so loud. Again, you can add a melodic musical element, but for the most part, you really have to figure out how the vocal melody is going to sit. And at the end, let's cut out the excess with the slice tool. Let's right click. So my melody would be something simple. Let's open up 3X OSC so we can get the melody out, and then we can replace the instrument later. So it's gonna go dent. So let's right click, open up piano roll. And I'll show you my idea. Now it's not gonna sound so computerized if a human would do it, but let's do it in piano roll. Let's add a little time delay, as if a human were to do it. You know, a human wouldn't sing right on the downbeat. Some people do, but for the most part, they delay their speech right after the transients hit, and that's where the vocal falls. So you create a time shift. This is called the pocket. I mean, it sounds pretty good with the sine wave, just as a reference tone. So this is helpful to kind of get the artist an idea of what you have in mind. But again, vocals have a completely different, you know, vowel sounds and different things about it. But it doesn't sound too bad. progression are pretty loud and they're taking dominance over the rhythm. You might want to pull back on those so it doesn't make the rhythm so kind of grayish sound. Have it, how to create a Timbaland style track. Now you can get these project files for free if you click that link below and sign up with your email. Now be sure to confirm your email. Okay, so when you sign up, it doesn't automatically just send you everything. You have to confirm that that's the correct email by going into your email and confirming and click the yes subscribing to the list button. Then you'll get another email with the download links and many more bonuses along with this project file. So click that link below or go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.